Show, what we got this week, KG?
Well, I was gonna ask you, since we're coming to the end of 39 weeks, how are you feeling about it?
I still feel good. I think the students have worked extremely hard in preparation for exams and finishing out the 9-week period real strong. Behaviorally, I think everything's going according to plan. It's gonna start getting hot at the spring break, so we'll probably come on with a few more announcements, just reminders to our students. I know spring break is coming up, students. Please be safe during spring break and make sure you get back to Westside High School in one piece. I want you to enjoy yourself, have a good time, so when we come back from the break, we'll be ready to and get focused on our academics and our behavior.
Okay. And all students, pick up yearbook applications in room 310. They are due March 27th. And yearbooks are on sale for $65. If you are unsure if you bought one, please check the bulletin board right outside room 310.
I also think students, make sure you get a yearbook. Those are keepsakes and things that you'll look back on after you finish high school. I still have my high school annual, and from time to time, I can refer back to it. We also have another movie clip that's coming from Ms. McGee's film studies class. The clip is from We Are Marshall Students. Again, last time, Ms. Gutshall and Ms. Tindall's class wrote me about what they got from it. You can discuss it with me, send me a letter about it, or just have discussions with your teacher or your classmates. We also will have Diversity Week this week. We have a lot of activities here. Ms. King Hanley put together some things for Westside High School. We're very proud of that. We're proud of the diversity at Westside. We see diversity in everything that we're doing as far as our courses, our athletics, our cheerleading. So again, diversity is all around Westside.
And do we have any home sporting events coming up this week?
We do. We have baseball, tennis, and soccer this week. I know baseball will have a big game with Greenville. How do you feel about that since you're on the baseball team?
We 3-0. We started off pretty good, but we got to keep pushing in the region.
Okay. I know soccer had some success as well. Beating Hamlin, they had a good have a good record in the region. So Westside, come out and support your sporting events. Our student-athletes deserve that, so come out and cheer them on. Westside, I'd also like to remind you about a tennis recovery. We will have a tennis recovery over spring break. Students, if you have any questions about that, please make sure you see Ms. Mitchell about spring break, a tennis recovery.
And also, seniors, prom. If you have not missed a day from March 9th to April 24th, you may receive a free prom ticket, one free prom ticket, and the first 50 students who have not missed a day from March 9th to April 24th will receive a prom ticket.
We'd also like to thank Ms. King Hanley and Jimmy Ann Mayfield for subbing for us on the Kory Roberts Show. They did a wonderful job.
Yeah.
We got a lot of competition now, so maybe we don't need to miss any weeks, but we certainly appreciate Ms. King Hanley and Jimmy Ann for keeping the show going. Go Rams.
I'm Chase Maxwell from Ms. McGee's Fourth Block Film Studies class. I chose the motivational clip of Speech of the Week from We Are Marshall. It shows you no matter what life throws at you, you just got to keep your head up to succeed. We are Westside.
For those of you who may not know, this is the final resting place for six members of the 1970 Thundering Herd. The plane crash that took their lives was so severe, so absolute, that their bodies were unable to be identified. So they were buried here, together. Six players, six teammates, six sons of Marshall. This is our past, gentlemen. This is where we have been. This is how we got here. This is who we are today. I want to talk about our opponent this afternoon. They're bigger, faster, stronger, more experienced. And on paper, they're just better. And they know it, too. But I want to tell you something that they don't know. They don't know your heart. I do. I've seen it. You have shown it to me. You have shown this coaching staff, your teammates. You have shown yourselves just exactly who you are in here. When you take that field today, you've got to lay that heart on the line, men. From the soles of your feet, with every ounce of blood you've got in your body, lay it on the line until the final whistle blows. And if you do that, we cannot lose. We may be behind on the scoreboard at the end of the game, but if you play like that, we cannot be defeated. And we came here today to remember. Six young men. And 69 others. Who will not be on the field with you today. But they will be watching. They'll be gritting their teeth with every snap of that football. You understand me? How you play today, from this moment on, is how you will be remembered. This is your opportunity to rise from these ashes and grab glory. Today.
Yeah! Hello, Westside. We're here on the Kory Roberts Show. We're starting off with our Ram Pride winners. We have a member from our concert band and a member from our soccer team. KG.
So, Peyton, tell us about the concert band's accomplishments.
All right. So, last Thursday, we went to Liberty High School, and we participated in the concert festival. And we got a superior, which is the highest score you could get. And this is the third time Westside has got a superior ever since Mr. Vickery came here for band. And the second time we got a superior was my ninth grade year. So, you know, making history two times in my high school career is really exhilarating.
Okay. Well, we're very excited about the concert band and real proud of y'all.
Thank you.
So, Emmanuel, I know we just broke a 15-year drought against Hannah. How do you feel about that?
It feels amazing to finally beat Hannah after 15 years of not beating them. It's the craziest thing to happen right now.
Okay, that's great. Well, you heard it here, Westside. We're very proud of our concert band and our soccer team. Keep up the good work, Westside.
Go Rams. Hello, Westside. We're here on the Kory Roberts Show with another segment about where our seniors are taking their talents to. We'll start over here to my left.
I'm Amy Hubbard, and I'm taking my talents to North Greenville University, and I'm going to major in broadcast media.
I'm Raymond Hendricks, and I'm taking my talents to Coastal Carolina University, studying exercise and sports sciences.
I'm Richard Nimmons, and I'm taking my talents to Greenville Tech and studying dental hygiene.
I'm Bethany Fisher, and I'm taking my talents to Greenville Tech to study to be a radiology technician.
Westside, we're very proud of our seniors and where you're taking your talents to. We look forward to our next group of seniors that we'll have around the table. Go around.
Hello, Westside. We're here on location with Ms. Boren, Westside High School's Teacher of the Year. Ms. Boren, how do you feel about being Teacher of the Year?
Well, I feel quite honored. I'm kind of shocked, actually. Didn't really expect it.
Okay. Why didn't you expect it? Because I come by your classroom all the time, and the students are really engaged, and it seems to be a lot of learning going on. I'm looking around the room. It's a lot of stuff around, a lot of boards in the back where I can tell that student-centered. How do you really connect with your students?
I do a lot of activities, and we do a lot of not so much sitting and just listening. We do a lot of interacting together. Instead of just me teaching and being the star of the show, I kind of just like the kids to kind of be in charge of, well, not in charge, but kind of do their own thing with their learning sometimes.
Okay, great. We appreciate you at Westside High School, and again, congratulations on being our Teacher of the Year.
Thank you.
Go Rams.
Hey, Westside, we're here with Mr. Tobin. So, Mr. Tobin, heard any good jokes lately?
Well, I'm a little upset because you guys haven't been to my office, so I got to have two jokes today. Okay. We've missed St. Patrick's Day.
Okay.
Have you heard about the population of Ireland?
I have not.
It's Dublin.
Ah,
capital, for you people that know anything about geography. The next one is, why did the dinosaur cross the road?
I have no idea.
Because the chicken hadn't been invented yet.
Okay. Well, Mr. Tobin, I got one for you. What animal has one more arm than a leg?
This is a good one. I don't know.
An armadillo.
Ah, I like that one.
You heard it here with Talking with Tobin. What's that? Have a nice day.